you have an old magazine that you just don't know what to do with and it's just getting in the way, well, I have an amazing resolution for you guys to turn that old magazine into an amazing wallet. Oh yeah. Hey guys, it's Lauren, Amateur Beauty Guru, and as you could tell from the title and the intro, we are making magazine wallets today. So this is what it looks like. You open it up, there's all this stuff, your money and your cards. So it was a pretty long process, not too bad. You don't have to do this part right here with the cards, you can just keep it with this. But I thought it was a super fun little thing, and let me show you the outcome of all this. Look at that. Ah. What is that? Oh. So I'm sorry if I look dead right now. I got up at 4 a.m. for an event I had to go to, and it is now like 6:30. I took a 5-hour nap from 9 to 2:30. So this took me, I want to say, about an hour. It was a really fun thing to do though, and it really passes time if you're bored or something. So without further ado, let us get started. Okay, so first what you'll need is a magazine that you either finished or had for a while, don't want to use it anymore, and you'll be tearing out the pages, so make sure you know you are ripping this apart. You'll need, this is optional, but I find a ruler helps a lot, so this is a broken ruler, but it still works the same. Some scissors, and some clear tape. I'm using the Scotch tape, heavy duty. This will, of course, help it stay together really well. It makes it a lot more durable, and of course, that's what you want in a wallet. So to get started, I already started this beforehand because it would take way too long on video. What you want to do is just start tearing out the pages, and it's super simple. So what you'll need to do is, you want to stay away from the thicker ones because most of these are the thin, and this is more thick. So let's say I'm going to use this. I might not. I'm not sure. All you have to do is carefully just tug on it. And it's not going to be perfect every time like this. It's going to be edgy sometimes. But, ooh, just kidding. Okay, so, yeah, it doesn't have to be perfect. Not like it's, like, torn halfway, but as best as you can. So that's what you want to do first. So to achieve this little thing right here, I will show you what to do. These are going to be like the thread of the whole wallet. So let's see what's a good one. Okay, so let's say I'm going to take this page right here. First of all, you have to choose which side of the page you want. I want this little area right here because of the product. What you want to do is, first of all, you have to choose what side you want because there's only going to be a limited space. So this is like a perfect size here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip it over. This is the side I want. I'm going to flip it over. Make sure this edge is farther away from you and you are folding inwards like this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take my ruler. Like I said, this is optional, but I find it helps. This is how thick it's going to be, and every single one is going to be about the same. So take the ruler and put it on the edge where it's the farthest out. See how it kind of goes that way, but I'm going to do it the farthest out. I'm going to take it and I'm going to fold it this way, best as I can, crease it, fold it again with the ruler. And make sure your ruler is outside of the magazine roll because it's easier to take out. And I'm just going to do that until the end. Okay, so I'm going to take it out because we're about the end here. And notice that there is a huge spot missing, or huge area right here that is not gonna look very good. You either can fold it one more time, like this, but it just kind of is in the way. So I'm just gonna take my scissors and kind of cut that off. Now, like I said, you don't have to, but it's kind of a pain and it will get in your way later on. So I cut it as straight as I can, and we're just gonna crease it so it's nice and creased up. Put this to the side in like a little trash pile, and we're just going, I kind of like this side better. So this is the side I'm gonna use, and I'm just gonna put it to the side here. See, I have a few already. And just do that until you get a good amount. And if you don't have enough in the end, you can just make more. Got a good amount, you want to line them up to you horizontally. So this is horizontally, that's vertically if you did not know. Now this is where your tape comes in. So first you want to make a tape that is about the length of the wallet magazine thing. And this doesn't have to be perfect because this is really just going to kind of hold it really quick. And we always can take them off. Now put that to the side and kind of line these up. Now I have 8 of them here because I want to have about an even amount so I can divide them. So once I get all this done, weaving and stuff, I'm gonna fold it over and it's gonna be perfectly the same. So there's gonna be 4 and 4, if that makes sense. As we go on, it will make more sense. Okay, I just kind of thought of this now. I'm gonna be taking this book here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna line these up here as best as I possibly can. Just line them up. I'm just gonna take the book and put it over, just so they stay in place for now. And then all you have to do is kind of line them up again. So once you have them about good, take your tape, and the tape should be half on the magazine and half on the table. So I hope you can see this. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect. It's the best you can do. So now they're pretty well on the table. Now we're going to take some more of these and weave them through. So how you weave? You can start wherever, whatever, like it's gonna go over, under, and so forth, and I'll show you. So what you want to do is kind of at first, so first, this first one, I'm putting it over, then I'm doing it under, over, under, and then there you go. Then I'm just going to kind of push it tauntingly to the end. Tauntingly as I can without breaking it. Oops. This time, for the second one, instead of doing it over first, I'm gonna do it under. So it's gonna be under, over, and just push it tauntingly. And like I said, just keep alternating over, under, over, under, under, over, under, over. As you can see, I weaved this whole thing. Now, it's pretty durable, but we want to make it more durable. So we're just going to take our tape again, and we're just going to make tape lines this way and make sure it's as smooth as possible. Area, and we're just going to do the same thing that we did in the beginning. So we're just going to take our last piece of tape. Sorry, it's going to be loud. So that's about good. And we're just going to do like half of it on and half of it off. And now we just want to take this off. So already here, my pieces of tape are on the edge. So you just kind of want to take it off and try not to do that. Try to take it off the best you can. Now this part, you really, really, really need to be super careful. So I got it off, flip it over. First, you want to do your sides. Tape the inside. What I'm gonna do though is, you can do it either way because this is gonna be the inside. It's not gonna be perfect. And all you have to do is tape. I think I'm gonna tape it this way because the tapes are there. You don't want to do it over. You want to do it until it reaches the tape here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is where I'm going to crease it here. So it's not going to be perfect. Kind of crease it so it's almost perfect. Crease it. It. As you can see, this is a pretty large wallet. I'm gonna go get a dollar bill so I can just kind of measure how big I want my wallet to be. So as you can see, I got a dollar bill here, and I want it to be like maybe half an inch from each side. You can get a pen and mark where you want it. Now I am just going to cut it here. This might take some strength, yes, but I believe in you. And we are going to make this again. I'm going to do it about half inch from the bottom and the top. Now you have like open edges here. I'm just going to tape that up. Then you can just cut off the sides here. So now we are going to make the pocket for your cash. So I am just going to estimate here. I'm going to make it about two little things here. And I'm going to tape these together first, just in the middle. Make sure they're kind of together first. And then whatever side you're going to have that's going to be flappy here, take another piece of tape first and do it half on and half off. And then put tape on the other side. Okay. So now that you got that done, take it and put it the edge that's going to be on the bottom here. Take another piece of tape. First, I'm actually going to do this. I'm going to do half on scissors. Okay. Then I'm just going to put them down here as close and even as possible. Crease it over. Okay. So as you can see, this is not even. So I'm just going to flip it over and cut it. Now it's just a flap here. I'm going to take little pieces of tape, do it half on here. And make sure it's not too long. Crease it. If there's extra tape on here, just kind of cut it. You have a pocket for your cash, so it's just going to kind of open up. So you can get a little Velcro thing here, but I am going to go above and beyond, and on the other side, I'm going to make a little credit card ID holder. So now in the inside, you have a place for your cash and your cards. So now to get it together, I'm using Velcro, but before that, I just found this little button that I hammered in because it had little tacks on it, and I thought it would be a cute little touch. So you can buy Velcro at like Hobby Lobby and stuff, and a lot of them have adhesive already on it so you can stick it, and there are circles you can buy. We didn't have those, unfortunately. I just found these. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to line these up on this edge here and cut them equally to a pretty decent size, which I think would be about that. So there you go. I cut it. So one side is going to be on one and then the other is going to be on the other. So I have a hot glue gun here that's warming up, and I'm just going to hot glue gun it. Okay, so once you got your Velcro down and hot glued on, You are finished with your little wallet. Yay!
Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed this. I hope it wasn't too frustrating. If you have any questions, because I'm guessing some people might have questions, go ahead and ask me in the comments below, because I know it was kind of complex, but I just thought it was so much fun, and it's so cute. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this. Like I said, go check out my channel, go check out my other videos, and it would be awesome if you subscribed. I forget where the camera is here. There you are. So that is it. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!